and waited for that second chance, for a prayer that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful wrists, memories seep from my veins. Let me be empty.
That heaven had visited ours, so I could just show and bring the news that she's getting older. And I wish that you met her, the things that you learned from me, I get them all from you. Can I just stay a while and we'll put all the world to rise. The little ones will grow and now still drink your favorite wine. Soon they're going to close, but I'll see you another day. So much has changed since you've been. That heaven had visited ours, so I could just swing by and ask your advice. What would you do in my situation? I haven't a clue how I'd even raise them. What would you do? 'Cause you always do what's right. I tell you that I'm scared of turning out a failure. Remember that the answer's in the love that you create. So much has changed since you've been visiting hours, and I would ask them if I could take you home. I know what they'd say, that it's for the best. So I would live life the way you taught me and make it on my own. I will close the door, but I will open up my heart. Since you've been away.
I didn't know today would be our last, that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb, I can't feel anymore. Praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. Gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on the side of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. Just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. You always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me when I'd fall. Took the only one I know. as close as I can, longing for the day when I see your face again. But until then, God must need another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight, singing hallelujah.
the only one he loves. I know you don't do it usually, but dear Lord, he's crying to dance with my mother again.
If there's medals for mothers, Mama, you'll win every one. I dreamed Mother walked up the heavenly stairs, and medals for mothers were given up there. They and never could see. If there's medals for mothers, for all of the deeds they have done, if there's medals for the biggest of all was the one for her love. If there's medals for mothers, for all of the deeds they have done, if there's medals for
this time to get forgiveness for my sin. I called to talk to Mama, and I know she's there with you. If there's a phone in heaven, then Jesus put me through. Told her while I still had the chance. But one day, Lord, you took her with no warning in advance. And I'm begging now, please give me one last opportunity. If there's a phone in heaven, let my mama talk to me.
Mike Manuel here. Thank you so much for watching.
You gave me a drawer in your kitchen. You gave me the room with a view of the yard. Whatever the hurt, you knew right where to kiss it. You gave me the best of your heart. And you carried my rocks in your pocket, flowers and feathers and butterfly wings. You had an answer for all of my questions. You showed me wonderful things. I know that it hasn't been easy. I hope that I loved like you do, 'cause I know that this world would be better if everyone had a mother like you.
I know it won't always be easy.
I know that my kids will be better if they have a mother like you. If I am a mother like you, 'cause I had a mother like you.
A stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light inside to the ones who lost the way, there's a place for people like you. Of all the days, a street made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. Your days down here are through, there's a place for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeves, and if you try to be the change you want to see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. Of all the days, a street made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to
rough and friends just trouble, water, I will lay me down like a bridge over trouble. When you're down and out, when you're on the street, when evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. Take your part. Ah, when darkness comes and pain is all around, like a bridge over trouble water, I will lay me down like a bridge over troubled water. I will lay me down.
Side. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to the funeral service of our sister Catherine. I now call upon the person delivering the eulogy to do so.
Church, good afternoon. Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. This opportunity was given to me to stand here to briefly eulogize on the life of a phenomenal woman named Catherine Modeste, better known as Norma Omahari, to most people from the community of Baden-Schulzel, where she hailed from. Norma was born on February 28, 1937, and was married to Richard Modeste, better known as Harry, from the same community of Baden, who have also passed to the great beyond, in other words, deceased. Norma was the mother of six children, four boys, two girls, a last son, now deceased. Norma had always been a hard-working individual who fended for her families in the early years. She worked on the various estates, namely Unionville, Ladofin, Fondu, Rabot, Montcubari, and Belle Plaine. Norma had always been a hard-working individual. Also a farmer by profession. She also established a good working relationship with all her working colleagues in her line of work. Belle Plaine Estate was where she retired as a farmer. Since farming was her passion, her children, namely Rufinus, also called Sol, Antonio, Conrad, and Sylvanus, now deceased, would join her on weekends and on school vacations to help in the gardening. Not forgetting to mention her main helper in all that she was doing, who helped from the start to the finish, Cletus, better known as Lapo. Cletus was the one who helped in harvesting the crops and transported around to sell. She had her customers well established. To her, Cletus was the son she never gave birth to. After retiring, Norma was liked by persons who came in contact with her, especially her customers. Everything came from her, her co-workers at various estates where she worked. A very helpful individual in the community of Baden where she resides. She lent a helping hand to neighbors and friends whenever necessary. Anyone who passes her way, rest assured, would not leave empty-handed. A loving and charitable person she was, and respected everyone. After retiring from all her hard work, she started spending quality time with her children in Castries, namely her daughter Priscilla and her son Rufinus, Sol, whom she visited regularly. Until there, she became a permanent home for a while, where she stayed with her son Rufinus for a short while and then became a resident of the Marian home in 2022 until her passing on March 1st, 2024. Special thank you to some of you who made a meaningful contribution during her lifetime and her latter days. Persons namely Angelina Alphonse, the Alphonse family, Paula Charles, for their patience and caring support, the entire Warden community for their assistance whenever needed. To her son Rufinus and sisters Alexander, daughter-in-law Louette Modeste, not forgetting management and staff of the Marian home, where she spent her final years. Other friends and well-wishers. Norma, you fought the fight and won the battle. You have now passed your legacy to your children, your grandchildren, and great-grand. Let them carry on your mantle. You'll be sorely missed by all who cared and loved you. Sleep on in the Lord. Rest in peace, my sister. February 28, 1937 to March 1st, 2024. Thank you.
Once again, welcome to the funeral service of our sister. Let us all stand as we're going to welcome her for the last time in this holy place.
Dear brothers and sisters, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Praise be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation. He comforts us in all our afflictions and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from Him. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bless the body of our beloved sister, Catherine Norma, with the holy water that recalls her baptism, of which St. Paul writes, "All of us were baptized into Christ Jesus, were baptized into His death. By baptism into His death, we were buried together with Him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with Him by likeness to His death, so shall we be united with Him by likeness to His resurrection." On the day of our baptism, our sister put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed with glory.
On this glorious resurrection week, the heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy as we join for entrance in the canticle of the sun. Glory of the Lord, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dance in the forest and play in the fields, and sing to the glory of the Lord.
listen to the song, the bringer of peace. He carries the light of the Lord in his words. The moon and the stars who lights up the way unto your throne. Everybody. Sing, sing to the glory of the Lord. They blow where they will, they blow where they please, to please the Lord. The heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Men dance in the forest, play in the fields, and sing, sing to the glory of the Lord. Go to the last verse. Praise to the death that makes our life real, the knowledge of laws that helps us to sing, the gift of yourself, presence with him to bring us home. The heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dancing the forest of pain, and sing, sing to the glory of God. And sing, sing to the glory of the Lord.
My dear brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for our sister that she may share in Christ's victory, and let us pray for ourselves that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened. May our hope of resurrection for your departed servant, Catherine Norman, also find new strength through Christ our Lord.
Amen. We're now going to listen to our scripture readings. So the first reader, please come up.
A reading from the book of Lamentations. My soul is shut out from peace. I have forgotten happiness. And now I say, my strength is gone. That hope which came from the Lord, brooding on my anguish and affliction, is gall and wormwood. My spirit ponders it continually and sinks within me. This is what I shall tell my heart, and so recover hope. The favors of the Lord are not all past. His kindness are not exhausted. Every morning they are renewed. Great is his faithfulness. My portion is the Lord, says my soul, and so I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who trust him, to the soul that searches for him. It is good to wait in silence for the Lord to save. The word of the Lord.
And I'll sing the 23rd Psalm. As I walk the path, the Lord is my shepherd.
you for the sake of his name. Though I walk through any valley, fear no harm, I know his word. He is broad and he is far. He is a man to the end. His peace my God, my good friend.
We're now going to listen attentively to our second reading.
Second reading will be taken from Romans 5, verses 5 to 11. And the Bible says, I hope it's not deceptive, because the love of God has been poured into our hearts by the Holy Spirit, which has been given on us. We are still helpless when at his appointed moment, Christ died for sinful men. It is not easy to die even for a good man, though of course for someone really worthy, a man might be prepared to die. But what proves that God loves us is that Christ died for us while we are still sinners. Having died to make us righteous, it is likely that he would fail to save us from God's anger. When we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, we were still enemies now that we have been reconciled. Surely we may not count on being saved by the life of his Son. Not merely because we have been reconciled, but because we are filled with joyful trust in God. Though our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have already gained our reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
In the joy of the resurrection, let's all stand to acclaim the good news as we sing our Easter Hallelujah. Hallelujah, the Lord is alive. Hallelujah, he left the tomb. Hallelujah, let us all rejoice, let us all rejoice, let us rejoice. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will never die. Hallelujah, the Lord is alive. Hallelujah, he left the tomb. Hallelujah, the Lord is alive. us all rejoice, let us all rejoice, let us rejoice.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowd, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I shall not turn him away, because I have come from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. Now, the will of him who sent me is that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. Yes, it is my Father's will that whoever sees the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, first of all, let me convey my heartfelt sympathies to all the family members, the near and dear ones of our departed sister. It's a moment of sadness and sorrow because someone whom we loved so much is no more with us in this earthly life. And today it is going to be the final time we see the body of our beloved sister in the physical way, physically in this earthly life. But at the same time, it should also be a moment of thanksgiving to the Lord God for the gift of the life of our beloved sister to be among us for the past 87 years. We have to remember, the Lord has given, the Lord has taken back. We cannot question God why you have taken her away, because it is the Lord who has given her to be among us all these times. And the moment when someone is born, it's a well-known fact that nobody is going to be alive in this world forever. The moment we are born, we know there is a moment for the end of the life on this earth. But at the same time, however long may be the life, what is expected of us in this earthly life is to make use of it in a positive way to continue to grow better. Because we are people who always like to have things better. We don't want the things the same way as they were in the past now. But we want everything to be developed to become better. And so the life on earth is given to us in order to make use of it to continue to grow better and better in our daily life. Because the life in this earth is not a reward that has been given to us, but it is a punishment. Punishment for the sins of the humanity. God created the human beings and kept them in his heavenly kingdom. Provided them everything what they are in need of to lead a peaceful and comfortable life. But falling into the temptation of Satan, the evil one, the first parents disobeyed God's word. They lost their trust in God and went ahead to follow what the Satan had told them, and so led themselves away from the presence of God. And even when they realized they have done against God and they are punished, they were not making an effort to come and look for God, but went away hiding, unwilling to accept their faults, instead passing the blame on others. And so it is the sin of the humanity, sins of the first parents, that led us away from God's presence, from his heavenly kingdom. Even though God has put us away from himself into this earthly life, still, he has not rejected us. He has given us a new life, forgiving our sins through his own death and resurrection. By shedding his blood on this earth, he purified the sins of the humanity and gave us a new life through the sacrament of baptism. When we are baptized as the children of God, purified from anything sinfulness, beginning with the stain of the original sin. Through the waters of baptism, we are cleansed and made as the children of God once again. And so as we continue to grow, life is not going to be something so easy. We have to go through so many things. But still, in as much as we are willing to follow Christ and to remain together with Him, we can expect everything better. Because with God on our side, nobody can do anything against us. In the first reading from the Book of Lamentations, we heard, "The Lord is good to those who trust Him, to the soul that searches for Him." In this earthly life, so much we see, so much we go through. But we have to remember, everything, whatever we may go through in this earthly life, is only temporary. Nothing of this earthly nature, we are going to have it forever. Whatever we acquire, whatever we look forward, whatever we go after, everything is there only for a short period. All these things are necessary for us. Everything of earthly nature is necessary for this earthly life, but for only for this earthly life. Because once we complete our journey in this earthly life, we are not going to carry anything of whatever we went after in this world. Nothing of it we are going to carry with us. Because when we came into the world, we did not come with anything. All what we are looking for, the wealth, property, money, all the riches, after which we go off, we go back, we go behind. Nothing of it is going to be there forever. These temporary things are meant for this temporary life on earth. But when the life comes to an end, we have to look forward. What are we gathering with us? What have we acquired, occupied, in order to carry with us into the presence of the Lord? That's what we have to be moving forward. This life on earth is only temporary. Life with God is eternal. The death of someone is not the end of everything. Many of us, we think, oh, once we are dead, that's the end of it. No. Death is only a gateway from this earthly life to the heavenly kingdom of God. When we are created, God created the human body out of dust. And then He breathed His spirit into the body to make the body come alive. And through death, the body and the spirit are separated. The body that was made out of dust is brought back into the presence of the Lord to give thanks to God for the life of our beloved sister and to pray for her and to carry it to become buried, to become part of the dust once again. But the spirit that was breathed into the body remains alive forever, and it is this spirit which is going to be eternally alive to find its place in the kingdom of God. Whatever we may do in this earthly life, everything we have to do it in order to make ourselves acceptable to God, to remain together with God. And it is this goodness, what we experience through our beloved sister when she was alive, that has made all of us to come and gather here to participate in the final earthly journey of our beloved sister's body. That's what we are gathered here, because of the goodness we experience. We are not here because she was a very rich lady. We are not here because she was a highly intellectual person, no. We are here because we have experienced something good, either directly from her or from her family members. It's the goodness that made us all to leave out all our other works and come and be present here. And we have to remember, our life has begun to be with God. And it is with God it has to go at the end. Even in this earthly life, we are not staying in one particular place all along our life. She has begun her journey in Shrosil, in this community. And then her life went through so many different places. But at the end, when she is dead, it is back to Shrosil. Her body is brought back. Where she started her earthly life, that's where she has come to complete her earthly life also. The same way the Lord God also expects us. He created us to be in His fellowship. And wherever we go, whatever we do, at the end, He wants everyone to come back to Him. He looks for every one of us to come back to Him. And that's what we heard in the gospel of today. All that the Father gives me will come to me. And whoever comes to me, I shall not turn him away. God is not going to reject any one of us. He wants every one of us to come back to Him into His heavenly kingdom. He is looking for us. And what can make us to be eligible to find our place once again in His heavenly kingdom? The kind of things we have done. The kind of life we lived. Just as if you have to enter into a country for a short time. We are questioned to find out what is our bank balance. What is our educational qualification. In what way we are acceptable to them. But for God, all what He expects us is whatever we have done for the others in goodness and love. Because Christ the Lord has said, whatever you do to others, it is to me you have done. The good things that we do towards each other, making use of this earthly life, that is what is going to make us eligible to enter into God's kingdom, to find our place in eternal life, in the kingdom of God, with everyone who is already there through a good holy life here on earth. But how many of us can say, I live my life with God? How many of us can say, I continue to follow Christ and remain with Him? I am not going after anything of evil or earthly nature. Earthly things are also essential, but they are not everything. They come, they go. But it is God who is going to be there with us forever. All the other things in our life you could see, from the moment we are born until this moment, we would have come across so many people. And many a times you would have thought, without this person, how am I going to survive? And at one point of time, they are gone, they are no more with us. But still, we continue to survive in this earthly life. Money comes, money goes. Wealth and property come, wealth and property goes. Nothing is going to be there all the time. But still, God is there to take care of us, to guide us and help us. If we follow the way of the Lord God will take care of us. We know so many times during the hurricane season, we have lost so many things. We would have thought, how am I going to manage? But still, when we trust in God, when we trust in others, the love of God and the love of others come to our rescue to help us to recover and move ahead. Yesterday there was a big earthquake in Taiwan. Buildings collapsed. But still the world will survive. The people will survive. They will move ahead. Because God is there. People come and go. God is there forever. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, let's remember too that God is the ultimate. Our life should be something that has to be lived with God in being good to each other. Whatever we do, it must be something good for the good of others and through them towards God. And so, our sister's life has come to an end at the age of 87. We are here because we feel she was so good. But at the same time, we know nobody is totally perfect. Everybody makes mistakes. We too make mistakes so many times. But When we return to God, accepting our faults and ask forgiveness, God is ready to forgive us and give us a new life. And we do not know whether our sister, when she died at the point of her death, whether she lived a good, holy life without any stain of sin, or whether she has done something wrong and never felt sorry to ask forgiveness. We do not know. We know only ourselves, how good we are or how wicked we are. We do not know about others. And so, as we gather together with the body of our beloved sister, it is also our necessity to do what we can to help our sister in her journey towards the kingdom of God, for finding a place in God's heavenly kingdom. And what can we do? We have done so much. A nice coffin, a nice dress for her body, and whatever the other things we have planned in her honor. All these things we have done for her dead body or for our personal satisfaction. But for her living soul that continues the journey into God's presence, for a place in the heavenly kingdom, there is only one thing we can do. That is to pray to God for her soul, that through our prayers, the Lord God can forgive her whatever that may be sinful in her. Accept her in his heavenly paradise and grant her eternal rest. That's the only thing we can do for her soul. And so, let's join together to pray for her soul, and for that, let us all stand now. Dear brothers and sisters, let us in faith call upon God the Almighty Father, who raised Christ his Son from the dead, as we pray for the salvation of the living and the dead.
After each prayer intention, we sing, O Lord, hear us, we pray. O Lord, give us your love.
We pray for the church and all those who proclaim the consolation of Christ's death and resurrection to families and communities in sorrows. Increase their faith and make them bearers of a lasting and meaningful hope. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our beloved Catherine Noma, who in baptism received the light of Christ and was given the pledge of eternal life. Scatter the darkness now, lead her over the waters of death, and share with her the joy of your kingdom. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the sorrowing families, relatives, and friends of Catherine Noma. Give us light to guide us out of darkness into the assurance of your love and courage to face the days ahead. Fill our hearts with your peace and strength during this difficult time, and grant us the grace to accept your will. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the sick and shut ins, especially in the community of Shuzel and the environs. May they feel your presence and peace, and may they know that you are always with them, even in the darkness of times. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all of us here today that the memory of our sister whom we love inspires us and renewed love for our brothers and sisters. We pray to the Lord.
May the prayer of those who cry to you benefit the souls of your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins and make them sharers in your redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our sister showed love and care to everyone who crossed our path. And now it is our turn to try a little kindness. This is our collection hymn. As we outpouring of our love in the collection. Standing by the road with a heavy load from the sea to shore. You're going the wrong way. You got to try a little kindness, but show a little kindness. Just shine your light for everyone to see. If you try a little kindness, then you'll overlook the kindness of a narrow-minded people on a narrow-minded street. Just shine your light for everyone to see. Of a narrow-minded people, of a narrow-minded sea. To come up to sign the register. You have Rufinus Modest, Antonia, Sixtus Alexander, and Conrad Donosi. And this time we continue expressing the goodness of God in our lives and in the life of our sister.
Dear brothers and sisters, with longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us all stand and offer our prayer to the Father as Christ the Lord has taught us. Our Father, before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Our sister was well known at the Victoria Chapel. Tells us today, don't worry, may life is in the hands of God. I'm going to be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. The troubles build up last always. For there's a friend in Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and sing. I know that I can stand, no matter what may come my way. My life is in your hand. With Jesus I can take it. With Him I know I can stand, no matter what may come my way. My life is in your hands. The test and trials, the same to bear to God. And all your friends and loved ones that know what to become. Remember that friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No, I can stand, no matter what may come my way. My life is in your hands.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord. Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to Himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister, Catherine Nurmer, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon our sister in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
On behalf of the parish priest, the choir, the musician, and all of you who have made it possible to come here to worship and in truth and in spirit, let us conclude by singing, I know nothing of tomorrow except the love of God will rise before the sun. I know nothing of tomorrow except the love of God will rise before the sun. The love of God will rise before the sun. I know nothing of tomorrow except the love of God will rise before the sun. The love of God will rise before the sun. Nation shake and earthquake wake and storm clouds sing together. Trouble seems as deep as black as night. Shades of gloom and threats of doom I see.
Thank you. to a land where joys will never end. I'll fly away. I'll fly away, oh glory. I'll fly away in the morning when I die. Hallelujah, by and by. I'll fly away.
Well, with stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dear rest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true. It's shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. I will cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
On the wings of a snow-white dove, he sends his pure, sweet love, a sign from above,
sign from above.
On the wings of a dove,
wings of a dove,
when troubles surround us, when evils come, the body grows weak, the spirit grows numb. When these things beset us, God doesn't forget us. He sends down his love on the wings of a dove. On the wings of a snow-white dove, he sends his pure, sweet love, a sign from above,
sign from above.
On the wings of a dove,
wings of a dove,
when Noah had drifted on the flood many days, he searched for land in various ways, troubles he had.
With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister. Together may we meet Christ Jesus. when He who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, "This is the will of my Father, says the Lord, that I should lose nothing of all that He has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day." Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory. For you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God. For you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our sister from this life to Himself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like His in glory. For He is risen, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise up her body on the last day. For our sister, Catherine Normer, let's pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die." And your response, "Lord, hear our prayer."
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for our sister, and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raised the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the repentant thief. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
With longing for the coming of God's kingdom, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Catherine Normer. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit,
Amen,
come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks
be to God.
Power of Leon. Be good.
Let's
should I give you, Lord?
Sing as sweet of a lullaby. The stars seem a little bit faded, the clouds just a little more gray, and it feels like things won't ever be the same. Heaven got another angel tonight. You left this world behind. Heaven got a little better today. It took you away from me. I'm missing you. See you again sometime. For now I'll close my eyes and dream of heaven tonight. The beaches aren't as lovely, the sky isn't quite as blue. Still there, sweetened by the memory of you. The rain is a little bit colder, the fire is never quite as warm. Still it seems that heaven isn't all that far. Heaven got another angel tonight. You left this world behind. Heaven got a little better the day. Took you away from me. I'm missing you tonight. I'll see you again sometime. For now I'll close my eyes and dream of heaven. With the things that mean a little bit more, I'm noticing the wonders of this world. I love with a little more hope now. I live with a little more peace, 'cause I understand how precious life can be. Oh, heaven got another angel tonight. You left this world behind. Heaven got a little better the day. Took you away from me. I'm missing you tonight. I'll see you again sometime. For now I'll close my eyes.
In the sand and help me understand where I'm going. You walked with me when I was all alone, with so much unknown along the way. Then I heard you say, I promise you I'm always there. I see my life flash across the sky. So many times have I been so afraid.
Smile, everything about you worth the while.